Excellent, excellent. Alright, we're going to take a few notes here today, just kind of review what we've done, and then we're going to go into maybe an example of them, and kind of do some in-class activities here. Okay, so let's start with factors.
Warren, do I have to remind you?
Oh, yeah.
What?
I totally forgot.
Eric wasn't going to forget.
No.
Enjoy. Remember, don't tell any other classes. Don't do that for other classes.
Yep.
So, all right. So, let's talk about factors, right? I want to talk, because this is what we did, Monday, Tuesday, right? Factors. I want to talk about how do I remember what these are versus what we did yesterday, which were multiples. Factors are pieces of a larger number. They're pieces of a larger number. How I think of, like, the word factors, I think of the word factory, and factories assemble pieces. So they assemble the pieces to make a larger object.
After notes, can I go to the restroom?
Yes. To make a larger item, right? Larger item. So that's what a factor is. You're placing pieces together to make something big. Well, on Monday and Tuesday this week, when we were talking about factors, we are taking numbers and breaking them up, right? So let me give an example of a factor problem. I think the homework we had, I think it was Tuesday, you had a problem that looked like this, right? It had a big F next to it, and you had a little tiny number, and what we were trying to do is figure out all the factors of 12. Well, what I want you to remember from that is I want you to remember that you're breaking this up into smaller pieces, chunks, right? Numbers that make 12. And so the big thing about factors is that you are still multiplying. You're multiplying numbers together to make a larger number. So it's what they call a product, right? That was a key word for multiplying. And a lot of you said, like, oh my gosh, I thought product meant adding, meant multiplying, right? That I need numbers that somehow multiply together to make 12. That's what we did Monday and Tuesday. So let's talk about these out loud. What are numbers you know multiply to give you 12?
6
and 2. Those are a good pair. 6 and 2.
12 and
1. 12 and 1.
Just let Eric go through.
What's another pair?
3 and 4.
3 and 4. Boom. Those are all the factors. Now, what makes a factor is that they're smaller pieces. Do you agree that most of these, anyway, are all smaller than 12.
Mm-hmm.
They're pieces that make it. Now, obviously, we have a bunch of sets, but I wanted all of them, right?
Every time you divide it, it gets smaller and smaller.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. When you divide, it makes things smaller. That's why the rule that I was teaching you guys is that I want you to put these numbers in order, going down 1, 2, 3, then you try 4, then you try 5. And what you did is you're supposed to take the big number, divide by 1, and here's your answer. Divide by 2. Gives you your answer. Divide by 3 gives you your answer. And that's what you did every single time. But I think we were kind of losing like what we were supposed to be doing. I was just kind of worried that you walked out of here and you didn't actually know like what was the purpose of doing it. It was trying to find pieces of a bigger number, what the smaller chunks are. So that's what we were doing. Now, obviously the definition we used in class, I think we said factors are the items that form a product, that form a larger number. So I think this is the best way to remember. Factory is like factory that we assemble pieces. We use the small pieces. Make sense? Okay. Mm-hmm. Ms. Stevens, or Ms. Edwards, sorry. Would you like to talk about multiples?
Okay.
Alright. I put you on the spot.
Oh, I went to a factory today.
Did you have a better way of explaining it than I do?
Well, I just gave my good old junior high thinking brain.
Yeah.
Got a color called like Mr. Moore does.
Old math teacher back.
Okay, I gotta go black now. Okay. Multiples, we get all the cards, which I forgot to bring.
Fine.
Okay.
We're good.
We were back there yesterday. What were we doing? What are multiples?
Going up by the number. So if it was 6, you'd blow up 6 every time.
Okay. So with Mr. Watts, you like you call it repeated addition. One thing that I didn't do yesterday that we need to, Mr. Ward reminded me, that we always want to start at 0. Like yesterday we started at whatever number we picked. So just a little, we need to make sure that we start number at 0. Okay, let's see. Steve, what's one thing you want to do this weekend? What's something fun you're looking forward to doing?
Working.
Working! Okay, where do you work at? Awesome, I didn't know that.
I knew that.
Do you work every weekend?
Mm-hmm. Every Saturday, and I work Tuesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays.
Ooh, okay. So we're going to say that Steve works every Saturday, every seventh day, even though you might really work some Tuesdays. We're just going to say Steve just works Saturdays. So we need to start at 0. So what is the next day he's going to work at? The seventh day?
14.
So what are you doing on the days in between? Nothing. Okay, let's see. Sam, what's something you're going to do this weekend? Okay, so let's say that doesn't happen very often. So let's have, since Steve, you helped us with prayer, let's see, Sam can help us with the friend. Let's say it doesn't happen as often as working. It's a special treat. So it's going to happen every 10 days. So we need to start at 0, 10.
20.
Oh, you got it. This is the Steve Sam. 20th day. 30th day, and then the 40th day. So not as often, but day 10, day 20, day 30, day 40. All right. Eric, what's something you enjoy doing?
No.
Fishing.
I have family
reunion. Wow, that's a, okay.
That's pretty cool.
Family
reunions.
Ooh, this, okay, so this doesn't happen very often.
Nope.
Hmm. Okay, let's pick a little bit tougher
100.
Number. All right. I'm going to say, I'm going to give you guys a chance to do this one all on your own. Okay? Before we put it up on the board. They're going to come every, like, 12th year. Okay, so on the first 5 numbers, and where do you always start? Okay, so the first one. Okay, so, all right, you have to know the next 3 on your own. You can use the calculator if you need.
The next 3 on your own?
The next 3 on your own. You can use the calculator. Doesn't happen very often. Every 12 years, Eric's family comes from Germany to visit.
No, I change bands.
Oh. I didn't know you could do that.
Yeah. I have like 24 different bands.
He's got so many.
I'm going to get one.
Alright.
Yeah.
Nice.
Don't you need an iPhone for it, though?
Yeah.
How about, isn't the new one coming out? You don't need one?
The new watch requires you to have a phone in first setup.
The next
and then after
the
phone,
you
can do it. So I don't have an iPhone, but I have to use my mom's.
Right?
Yeah,
you have to use my mom's. For the next year, I went to years.
I mean, just for looks. Just say I have this watch, or just get a Rolex. $20,000.
I'll repeat an addition.
Or grills.
Yeah.
Get custom grills. One custom girl to say,
got it.
Munson. Or Money Munson. Ah.
I can see that.
This YouTuber has girls with his last name.
No.
And then he bought, they were $10,000 and he bought his friend a Rolex Ambrose.
Well,
so you spent $30,000 on his friend.
That happens. And now what's in 12 days? What day is that, or in what year is that going to be?
But he has his own merch.
Let's take this and put some 12
like
days.
Brand.
They got number plus 12.
He bought a G-Wagon, and they only made a certain amount of those.
Okay.
He just bought a bus, like one of those short buses.
So
in
12
decked
days,
out.
What number are we going to be at then?
He has spikes on the wheels. Has like a platform on the top, has a bathroom, a stove in it, has like love sacks, he has like a bunch of stuff in it.
Okay, see, we give us, so, doesn't happen very often. You guys work up here every 7th day, and you have a friend over every 10th day, but Eric's family comes and visits every 12th year. So 0, then 12. See, what's my next year?
24.
They're going to come in the 24th year, and they're going to come?
36.
The 36th year, and then they're going to come?
48.
The 48th year.
Four
could
decades.
Could we keep going?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you get multiple, tonight with the Olympian, there could be multiple people there. There could be lots of people. There could be lots of choices. We usually just pick, like Mr. Ward will say, the first 5 or 6, or he'll let you know how many that you have to go. But one key we have to remember to start at?
0.
Okay, this is where it gets tough. What's the difference between the factors and the multiples?
One goes up by 2. Well, you divide with that when you add with multiples.
Okay, so you're saying that this one you could like divide to figure out all of your factors.
Yep.
And this one you're doing repeated addition. Good. Any other things? How can you keep them straight? Because they're two different things. Mm-hmm. What was Mr. Ward's awesome shortcut that he shared in the word factors? What word does it remind him of?
Factory.
Factory. What do you do in a factory?
Create things to make.
Yeah, you get things out of, like, yeah, you take little pieces, right? So he's saying that's where you're going to have all of your pieces listed.
I went to Stellar today and that's what they're doing.
There you go!
They have robots that build for them.
So there you go. Now you're going to remember all your factors and all the little pieces.
They said that they make. They make, for every 12 minutes, they make one crane like make a crane part every 12 minutes. That's a lot.
Nice. All right. So, they're going to sit down. Very nice. All right. So, so here's what we're going to do today for a little in-class activity. Because we've walked through all of these, and we've talked about how can you remember them, we did some examples, these are actually awesome, I love the calendar idea. Now I want to see, can you replicate it on your own? Can you keep them straight and figure out, you know, factors, multiples, if I give you a jumbled list of them? So here's what I like to do. So we have some, all right. Perfect, okay. So. So everyone has a little tile in front of you. All you're going to have to do today is write your answers on the tile. We even provided you with a little like rag so you can clean it off. There are certain answers we're going to look at, and we're going to check each person's. And you can work at your own pace. You can pick any problem that I'm going to put on the board right now first. Okay? So here's what you have to do. On your tablet, and before you're done, you show one of us your answer, and we tell you yes or no. And then you can move on to the next, and you can pick whatever one you have. Okay? So one of the things you have to do is you have to give me your own definition. Marker is dying. You have to give me your own definition of these two words. How would you describe it to somebody else that was not in this room? Factor and multiple. So that at some point you have to start there. Okay? Does that make sense? So somehow write your own little definition. Second. So after you're done with that, we check and we say yes or no, and you got to make a definition of each. Then you got to find the factors of these three numbers. One at a time. So we'll check one, you can erase it, check another one. You have to find the multiples of these numbers. And when you're done today, you're done. And you can enjoy your candy, you can relax.
Yeah, I'm already down to one.
Okay, so. Down to one. So, we'll walk around the room. I want your definition of factors and multiples. So, at one point, we'll check those. I want the factors of these numbers, so you do one number at a time, and we'll check it. We'll tell you yes or no. And then I want the multiples of those. And you can work at your own pace. You can start with any problem you want. And we'll check it.
Nice.
Check that again. Do you read that too fast?
Yeah.
should you start?
Yeah,
be good.
You're right.
There's only one half.
There's just, there's the two, there's the one.
Okay, can you do a child thing today?
That was actually really good.
Okay.
Nice.
I'm gonna say, I already have that, this is Edwards.
Rattle it off. Good.
I have like two.
Already have it?
Three dots.
Alright. Con.
Every.
Positive. Why?
That's it.
Okay.
But it's really warm.
Okay, cause there's the one.
He likes to, I think he likes to.
Good.
Play chess.
Play chess, okay.
Alright, nice.
Oh, likes to play chess every sixth day. On what day will we both have something to do? Okay, see, we can. I look for it every fifth day.
Yes, I.
And that's your word, I can play chess every sixth day.
Good, nice.
Fabulous word, correct spelling and everything. How did you know to stop here and not like keep going and trying like five, six?
Keep going.
Keep going.
And then when I got like to eat, he knew that one.
Perfect. That's gonna be like, you're fun about.
Mm-hmm.
This is another clue too, as soon as it's the same number.
It's that.
Then that's as far as you can go, yep.
Thirty.
Okay, I'm gonna give you one more.
He's good.
I know.
He's playing.
I didn't even talk, I said that, if, did you see my problem, Mr. Ward?
Yeah, I did a story problem, I mean.
Yeah, okay, give me some more. Okay.
Alright.
Gonna give him a.
Why? Why is, you're right.
I'm going to.
What?
When you see the same number.
Go running.
Wait, I agree, when you see the same numbers, you're down, right? Can't go any further, but why is one three composite? What makes it composite?
Cause it's three factors.
Exactly, there's more than one.
Every fourth thing.
Nice, keep going, nice, nice.
And Mr. Ward is gonna go, he's gonna go running every.
So, I think you still have the multiple still.
Six day, one day, we end up running.
And they're directions, yeah, so that's right. And you're almost there. Plenty of them.
Be careful.
Thought I could stop you on that.
It's actually forgot what the con did. Thanks.
Cause they both add up to the same thing, then if they both like hit the same number, then yeah, the answer.
It's impressive, that takes some serious logic.
Awesome.
Nice. Nice. That's cool.
Same.
Feels like an explainer.
Is there any number that can be between four and five?
No.
So that's how you know that you can be done. Okay, so just like five or composite number?
Composite.
Why?
More numbers.
Yes. Awesome.
Yeah, these guys are dormant today. You guys are firing all cylinders on a Friday. That's impressive.
So Fridays, I don't know, even on Monday. You're all.
It's really not on Friday.
Then you give us sugars.
Give me sugar, man. It's just like giving me more sugar every day. It actually does help brain stimulation, by the way. It does make you actually smarter, I'm sure.
Might as well start doing that, man.
I'll keep that in mind.
So you got the doctor's down then?
Oh, crap.
Killing it.
What homework do I have?
Let me check.
Do we even have any homework?
No, we had homework earlier this week. That was basically it. You guys all turned it in. Building the block though? No, I'm not gonna.
Okay, so what are the, like, okay. You guys are biking every 4 days.
Repeat it.
Nice, right?
Yeah, it is.
So every 4 days you get to do something.
Man.
What do you mean by that?
Like that big one?
Okay, so I wanna know like, I wanna know. So you go biking every 4 days, you bike on the fourth day, what's the next day that you go biking then? So yeah, you start at zero.
I get it.
Then day four you bike, what's the next day you get to bike?
So the three.
You just wanna write on 16 or something?
I mean, eventually, but I get to bike before day 16. I get to bike every 4 days.
Zero.
Okay,
did
so
you already do
if I started at zero, then to four, number correct, then there can be multiplied by to get to the numbers. Can you draw the checklist? I'm gonna try the first one, number four. I'll see if you clean up your.
Would be eight.
Okay. Nice. Steven, you're firing all cylinders today. I like it.
And then 4 days it gets right on back again. So not quite. That's not in 4 days. Every fourth time. How could you use your calculator and help it out? You're on day eight.
Plus it by four.
Thanks for the help, Steve. Like that happens in every 4 days. Okay.
Nice.
So then, 4 days,
yeah.
I get to write my bike again.
Before your race, because you're right.
So every time you get a number, you just plus it by four and you keep going.
Okay. Yeah, thanks. Okay. So you get to write your bike on day 16, but you were missing day 8 and day 12 in between that. Okay. All right. Next one.
Multiply.
Okay, so are they bigger or smaller than the original?
Bigger.
Yeah, usually. Okay. Except the first two. Right.
So you're gonna go
bigger numbers.
Play video games every 11
days. Yeah, multiple people come to your family reunion. Big numbers.
You got it, there's the pattern. That's kind of just recognizing the pattern.
Weird.
Okay, so what are multiples, Sam?
Southern German.
Okay. I think there's some in German. One of the countries I want to go to
very, very
that big.
Got it.
Nice.
You got them all here?
Yep.
Alright. Alright. Did you have 11 stuff?
No.
And 25 of them.
Careful, not by, why are you adding a big 2? Every 25 days. How do you get from 11 to 22?
Come on, buddy.
And then day.
Come on, buddy. You're?
Yeah.
You got your kicks.
Right, one more.
Yeah. Those are sweet. Let me see the bottoms of those. Oh, yeah.
I'm ready because we have a stellar thing for medals and bad cap on kicking mud.
Oh,
okay.
I put
it. Yep.
Nice. Take it back. Nice. Good work.
Got it.
Microfibers are good.
Click on what? Miss Lyons said no.
And senior.
Hey, you ever play a game of war with me?
War?
Yeah.
How do you play that?
Sure.
Never played a game of war.
You have to have, when you keep putting cards down,
Alright. We're calling this multiplication war. Just everyone turn your desk. We have it face this one. We can be in two pots. Okay. Alright. Let's do practice on getting everyone on the same page. If you get an ace, that's a one card. If you get any face card, like jack, queen, or king, those are worth tens. So start, flip your first card over. And 7 times 9?
63.
Got it. Okay, so you get to keep all your cards because you each got it right. Alright, so flip your next card over. If you don't get it right, I get to take your card.
Oh, jeez.
Okay.
Isn't this also a 10?
8, yep. So 8 times 10, you get to keep it. 8 times 2?
16.
Keep it?
80.
80, I'll keep it. 10. 70. Keep it?
30.
Keep it?
60.
Keep it?
Ooh.
Yep.
50.
Yep.
90.
Yep.
20.
Yep.
60. No.
You can fix it?
12.
Okay.
Just put an essay.
Give me.
No, that's fine. Okay, you keep it.
50.
Yep.
80.
Yep.
30.
Oh, I need a card, you guys.
100. No, wait.
This is a 1.
10.
Yep.
10.
5.
Yep.
80.
20.
40.
Uh-oh.
70.
Oh. Where is that thing? You have it.
That's easy.
28.
Okay.
And 70.
Okay. The last card, last round.
Oh, geez.
Yep.
7.
Yep.
6.
Okay. Alright, so this is how we're going to play multiple choices. It's a good warm up. Sword, did you have other cards you said?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay.
No calculators.
Alright, you can still use calculator if you want.
Oh, nice.
But now we're going to play, Steve and I are going to play against each other, so we'll need. You guys can use the big cards this round. Okay, and Steve and I are going to use the small cards. Is that how it works? Split the deck in half.
And I need a card.
Just make sure.
Okay.
We'll just do one quick shuffle. I think you can shuffle. Those should be pretty good.
I need a joker.
Okay. Then the winners, pick on the winners. You can use a calculator. Eric, do you want to grab a calculator from Mr. Ward?
Keep the joker.
Do you each have one?
Okay.
Then.
Okay.
Do you have a
calculator
too? That one's
too?
Okay.
Well,
grab
one's
it.
Over there.
Well, I think Eric,
just
grab it. There you go.
Give him the lid on that one.
I love this game. Alright, thanks for playing with me.
I see why you like this game, because it's actually kind of fun.
It's super fun. Okay. Can you see your other cards, Eric? Thank you. So we'll cut it in half. Alright, Steve and I will demonstrate, but then really, like, you guys are our game, and we're two separate games. This is how it's played. You turn the card at the same time, and then whoever can say it, so Steve gets both cards. Oh, we just threw that one away.
30.
Oh.
18. Okay.
90.
Yep, so there you are. Okay. Alright, so you go through the whole deck, and we'll count your cards at the end.
35. No,
100.
Nice.
60.
Mr. Ward, can I get a calculator too, please?
Yes.
20.
Nice.
100.
90. No.
I'm gonna get my 9 type.
10 have kids, 100.
10.
Got it.
100.
2.
Ooh. 40.
Nice.
70.
Mm-hmm.